Welcome, everyone. I'm so excited to see a full house. So happy that you're sharing your evening with us. It's just so great to have you here. So I've wanted to do that piece for several years, and with this exceptional group of people that we have this year, it was wonderful. And I also decided, you know, I would love to do this with orchestra, because typically it's an a cappella piece, which means there's no accompaniment. So anyway, orchestra, thank you for adding such a beautiful piece to that. Lovely way to start. So tonight's program, we've got two requiems, and they're different. They're still requiems, but they're different. So this first one, Cherubini, so when it was written a couple of centuries ago, when they were writing requiems, the point was to pray for the people who had died, to make sure that they had safe passage, to make sure that that they were cared for well, that they were at peace, all of those good things after they had passed. So so this is a typical requiem setting for a mass, and it's an incredible piece. Cherubini is hardly ever heard of nowadays, but it's a lovely find, and I hope you enjoy it. It's a wonderful, wonderful piece, and welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you.
fantastic. Thank you so much. We're going to take a little bit of an intermission, so we have our president who's going to, while you guys go ahead and go off, so they can have some time to sit down. But just a little bit of intermission if you want to just stand up while you listen to Joyce. She's just got a couple of things to share with you guys. And the second half is another requiem. It's just a little bit different, and I'll explain to that. I'll explain that when we come back. We'll see you soon. Joyce.
Thank you, Ricki. Greetings and good evening. Thank you all for coming. It's wonderful to see the sanctuary so full. We also have several people watching online. I'd like to begin my remarks by sharing a story with you. My comments are very brief, so you still have 10 minutes after I'm done speaking. On a hot July afternoon in a church with no air conditioning, a bunch of strangers made it past the security door and into the fellowship hall. They were curious, maybe a bit anxious, but most definitely new to this experience. They each found a seat and opened their music, timidly at first, then parted their mouths and let out sounds that were not quite music, not yet. But over time, their nervousness disappeared, and with encouragement and guidance and a bit of humor thrown in, their voices became stronger and melodies formed, and then harmonies, and full chords emerged. Voices arching and dipping and blending found tempo and dynamics. They began to sustain notes together and breathe together, and eventually their many voices became one song. And then something magical happened. Sometimes unpredictable, sometimes it doesn't happen at all, but this time the music captured their hearts and broke them open, filling the air with powerful emotion. The beautiful sounds they were making delivered to the audience what the composer surely intended for the piece, even though it was written over 200 years ago. That's why it's called a movement. We are moved by choral singing, and I hope that you felt that passion and that longing and the grief and the love and the deliverance in the music that you just heard. This is our 11th season for the Metropolitan Choral Festival, and we are growing. We have over 50 new singers that joined us on stage this evening, bringing their talent and passion with them. And if you noticed in the program notes online, they represent over 31 choirs throughout the Denver metro area, from south of Denver all the way up to Boulder. We have new board members as well, bringing new ideas and fresh perspectives to our leadership. And we have renewed our dedication to secure a grant from the Science and Cultural Facilities District to help underwrite our annual summer season. The application is due in March, so please wish us luck. In the meantime, though, we continue to rely on your individual generosity and financial support. And believe me, I'm very touched by many of you who dropped money into the basket on your way in. Thank you. Thank you very much. For the rest of you, do give what you can before you leave tonight, and any amount is welcome. If you use the QR code on the program, it'll take you right to our donation page, and you can use a credit card online, or just drop a cash or check in the basket by the door on the way out, or if you prefer, mail us a check when you get home, that's fine too. Your name as a donor or your company's name will remain on our website for a full year as a supporter of the Metropolitan Choral Festival. Again, thank you for being here and for bringing a bit of magic into our lives. May the music fill your soul. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back. So, Dan Forrest, if any of you have ever sung choral or solo music, you'll know Dan Forrest, and he's just an incredible composer. I just love everything he's done. We did his Jubilate Deo a couple years ago, and very fun. So this is probably one of the most moving works you will ever hear. So the Requiem that we did the first half was all about the person who had died, give them peace, all of that kind of stuff. So this one is more for us who are left behind. So we've all had somebody who's passed away who's important to us and dear to us, and there's a journey that we need to go through, and that's what Dan helps us do in this particular piece. So helps us work through the grief, helps us find the joy in remembering the person that we lost from this earth. It's an incredible piece, and this chorus absolutely loves it, and they're going to sing it beautifully. So again, thank you so much for being here, and this is the Dan Forrest Requiem for the Living.
Thank you. Thank you.
You liked it, didn't you? It was pretty amazing. Pretty one of the most amazing works I've ever done. I start to get emotional at this time because the summer's done and I'm gonna miss you. I will. It's been a great group of people. It's been a great summer. Our board has worked really hard. Joyce, our president, all of the people that are working so hard on our board, and it's been a wonderful summer. So thank you so much for sharing this evening with us. We finished the program with a blessing. It's one of our favorites, John Rutter's A Gaelic Blessing. If you read the program, it was dubbed a garlic dressing. Yeah. His friends called it that when he composed it. Anyway, so we're going to end with a Gaelic blessing. After we're finished, please join us at a reception in the fellowship hall over to the, what would that be, west. But thank you. This has been an incredible summer, an incredible evening. Philip and Eric, thank you so much for putting together such a wonderful orchestra. You've been an absolute pleasure for me to work with. Thank you. And choir, you have truly blessed my life. So thank you so very much. So bless you as we leave this evening, and please enjoy a Gaelic blessing.